The biggest thing I can say about this adaptation, the biggest compliment I can pay it, is that when I finished watching it, I was a bit like, oh my God. And then I was like, I made this up. Why am I so disturbed by it?
They're both happier with me than they are with each other.
You shine.
What about your wife?
Is it happening again, David?
I'm Sarah Pimbra, and I am the author of Behind Her Eyes. I wanted to write about an affair because I'd been reading the kind of Gone Girl, you know, psych thrillers, and I realised that was kind of the direction I wanted to go in. So I thought an affair is a great setup for a thriller because you're automatically dealing with lies and deceptions and secrets. I wanted to kind of add something a little bit different in, but I'm a massive dreamer, so I wanted to put in something about dreams, and then I thought that gave it a slightly different flavour. My writing history comes from, I started off writing horror, and then I started to write fantasy, and then I moved into crime. So I wanted to weave those kind of two things together, and I just thought it would give it a kind of gothic flavour. So I wanted to kind of lean into this alternate life we all lead in our sleep. And then I wanted to add in a murder, obviously, because, you know, it's a thriller. Then I was really stumped, and I thought, oh, this is not sounding anything original at all. And then I went to the pub, had a glass of wine, sat down in a panic, and then the ending just came to me. Once I had the ending, I thought, oh, this is going to be a little bit different. The ending is a very divisive ending. It is a love or hate. It's been described as a Marmite book. It spawned the hashtag WTF that ending. For me, it's really interesting to read other people's opinions on it, because when I planned the book, I had the ending in mind. And I understand that there are going to be people who really don't like the ending, and there are people who really love the ending. But the one thing that has always irritated me is when people say, oh, she's just thrown that ending in, or they've just thrown that ending in, which I'm sure that, you know, people will hear with the TV, but actually it's plotted all the way through. So I don't mind that people hate it, but when they say, oh, how are you supposed to see that coming? I want to say, go back, read it again. The clues are all there. It's just how, you know, how you read the book. We had a lot of film and television interest in the book, even before it came out. When Left Bank were interested, I really didn't want to sell it to television. I think it was that kind of, I wanted a Gone Girl film or a, you know, Girl on the Train film that hadn't been made yet. You know, and everything was about film at that point. But when I had the meeting with Left Bank, and they were so driven about the story, and they really understood the story, and they were so purposeful, and they were like, we will get this made. So I was like, okay, great. I came out there and I was like, yeah, I really want to sell it to them. And then it was just great, because someone at Netflix also wanted it after this meeting. Obviously, Netflix, Left Bank already made The Crown together. So it was just like a really happy marriage coming together again, I think. And I was very lucky that it was my book that they worked together on. It does feel a bit odd when you first hand over your book to someone else to adapt. You always have a little part of you that is like, oh God, are they going to wreck it? But I had such faith in the team. And then when they got Steve Lightfoot on board, and I loved his work, Hannibal is one of my favourite shows, so I thought he can get this very Hitchcock Polanski kind of vibe in his writing and Eric in his filming. I was kind of excited to see, because I would not want to adapt it myself. I'm, you know, especially then, it was 4 years ago, and I was thinking, oh, how are they going to do this? I'm really curious to see how they actually tell the story. You know, Steve has been so gracious with it, really, and very, very faithful to the book. So I'm actually quite happy with everything. And I probably would have been happy if they changed it. It would have been interesting to see how they would have changed it. So I'm quite laid back about these things. There are things that are different in the series than the book. Although now it's really hard for me to imagine it, to remember them, because I'm so visualize it as I see it on the screen now. Louise's character is different. In the book, she was slightly overweight and less attractive than Adele, and kind of, you know, smoked and drank too much. And they've kept the smoking and the drinking in. But Simona's obviously really beautiful and slim. But actually, that has worked really well, because was I writing that character now? You know, I wrote the book 5 years ago, 4 or 5 years ago, and I probably would have given her more interesting insecurities than just, oh, I want to lose a couple of pounds and stop smoking, even drink less, even though that is the kind of thing that we all do sort of think about all the time. So Simona does Louise better than my Louise, I think. So it's actually worked out really well. But stylistically, it's just a really beautiful piece. And I can't think of anything that I would have imagined entirely differently. I mean, the house Adele and David live in is maybe slightly grander than the one that was in my head, but I, you know, those are tiny things. And the doctor's office is very modern, which I imagined a very old building, but I love the way they've done it and how thematically even the building ties in with the themes and the images that go through the book are kind of reflected in that doctor's office. And now, if I think about David, Louise and Adele and Rob, that the cast are the only people I see, it's really interesting. I had no idea how they were going to either write or film the weirder elements of the book, of the story. And I think actually I was a little worried when I first watched it that maybe it gave a little too much away, but that's because I know the story inside out, back to back and whatever. But I actually think they've done it the best way they could do it, so that when people look back, they should be able to go, ah, I see now. You know, and maybe in the last episode, they'll start to get what's going on.
Count my fingers.
Stay calm and focus.
We're just as messed up as anyone else.